As the weather outside is becoming grimmer, my thoughts go back to the summer. During the third day of Øyafestival, Jack White was the headliner on the main stage, but I really wanted to see Arca, who performed at the same time and is one of my favorite musicians out of the new ones. I missed most of the Loyle Carner concert, but from the bits I've heard, it was a concert that exceeded expectations. With live instruments on stage, good singing, good energy with the crowd, and a lot of happiness from the artist. So I hope he comes back soon, and I will make sure to not miss it this time. Here we are at the Air concert. The chill electronica merged very well with the strong sun. I had some personal business to attend at this concert because I remember Air from the times of my primary school and I was curious how it would sound now. First, I could hear literally decades of French achievements in the field of pop and electronica that were carefully implemented into a 90s album. Literally, very French. Like someone put the yeah pop filter over ambient music. That's something I definitely didn't hear as a young person. The second thing, a lot of their songs could be tagged as easy listening library music. It's honestly background library music, most of their stuff. But the third thing, their famous hits still sound good and sound extremely pleasant. And if you wonder if my Rateyourmusic nickname Cherry Blossom Girl is from an Earth song, yes it is. And I'm very glad that I could hear this song live.
Thank you.
White is the most famous artist of Polish origins in the industry right now. If you don't know, his mom is Polish and he's visited Poland many times. But I've never had a chance to see him in my own country, even though I loved the White Stripes at high school. Well, I was mostly scared of people and going to concerts, so this explains a lot. The interesting fact is that Polish people are the largest ethnic minority in Norway. There are more Poles than Swedes, for example. In the end, it was also a fitting place to see Jack White's concert. This concert was surprisingly short for a headliner, but we could still hear hits from The White Stripes, The Rencontres, and songs from the newest Jack's solo album. The album that I must add is really good. It's raw, energetic, has ideas, has catchy riffs. I know that saying that the garage rock album sounds fresh in 2024 sounds like a joke, because how can it be technically possible? But yeah, Jack White has pulled it off out of his love for music.
Yeah.
most of the time close to the stage, and from there I could see why Arca doesn't give concerts often. It takes a lot of internal energy to give such an empathic connection to the music and audience. It's like literally giving birth to a performance. And as for the audience, it felt like attending a sonic spa. We paid for a ticket, we entered, we were getting pampered. The concert was special because Arca was improvising. She didn't prepare the set list, she was playing whatever her mood was for, or like I said, she asked the people. As a creator myself, I can tell you that the best things happen when the artist and art become one and burn themselves through the act of creation. But after that, you have to recover mentally a lot, and that's how this concert looked like to me. Prada.
Because there's no set list. Wait, stop, sooner stop. You know that there's no set list. I'm doing something different today. See, I'm choosing the song that I want to play in the moment. So like, after seeing you like mosh, I low key was like, okay, let me zoom up. Okay, listen. Thank you. Rodava.